think we had a network outage there, so I'm just making sure everything's set back up right. Still got barrels on my fingers. I think we're back up and running again. Not quite sure what happened to my internet then, but everything, absolutely everything cut out then, which is unkind. So I've just been working on some barrels. I've just done the silver. I'm just going to give them a couple of minutes to dry before I try and take them off my fingers, because I think they'll just go everywhere otherwise. It's a bit of a shame it cut then. That was bit annoying, not quite sure what happened there. I think these are okay to take off my fingers now. Leave to one side to finish drying. Two more to do. Just moving the barrels just so I don't knock them over. So again, I'm painting with lead balcha. Hey King Manadoc, thank you, they're looking really good actually. I've got a couple of completed ones here. Oh, that's the bad side. Got a couple of good ones here. But yeah, they're coming out really good. Been a bit messy though. I'm going over with shade paint anyway, so I think that might hide a few of my sins here. I'll do very well today. My stream just cut out a few minutes ago, so I've had to just relaunch everything, so I'm a little bit annoyed at that. It's probably my problem. I need to concentrate. Ugh. when the lead belch is dry. I'm gonna go over the wood a little bit, a few areas. Oh. Or a lot of areas, it seems. Oh, you've never had the urge to paint a barrel before now. I must admit, I wasn't gonna have any barrels as part of my scenery set, but actually I found the file on Thingiverse and got them 3D printed, and yeah, I'm kind of in love with them now. So I've got 5 that I'm working on. I've done a couple more up to my fingers, so I've ended up surrounded by little barrels, but I think they'll just kind of just look good in the corner of some scenery, just give it a bit more atmosphere, a bit more lived in. Working on the scenery so I can take some awesome photos of other models, so it's taking a bit. Can I rotate this? Yes. There we go. Super easy to paint as well, because I mean, I've just used some contrast paint. I then put the lead belcher on, put some shade all over, and it's pretty much complete. Super, super easy and quick to do. These barrels are open, so obviously I need to do the inside as well. So some finished barrels have got a black interior just to kind of help them out a little bit. Give them a couple of minutes to dry on my fingers before I can attempt to get them off. Nope, definitely not. It'll be okay. There we go. Ones that I did at the beginning, oh, they're still a bit tacky, I can feel them. And that serves in a bit, I think. The next thing I've got is this scenery piece. I've got the skulls to just redo because I've got quite a bit of my base paint all over him, so I just need to go back over my skulls. I'm staring at my fingers trying to figure out if I can fit a mini barrel. Well, I have to say these are extremely, extremely small barrels. I mean, I will give you a reference point of how small these are, so. Oh gosh, breaking my desk. Extremely, extremely small. Honestly, I don't really know how else to paint them because the whole exterior I've just been going around the edge. And then at the end, very last thing I've done is the interior. But yeah, I'm not quite sure how else you'd paint them other than to potentially like find the end of a pencil or something and hold them on. Let's get these skulls done. So I'm using the Screaming Skull layer paint. By the way, I've been through and thinned an awful lot of my paints down, so if I'm using them straight out of the pot, it's they're not straight out of the pot at Citadel's thicknesses. Just makes it easier for me to have it ready to use than having to mix every paint every time. Not that I'm cutting corners or anything. Maybe some sort of stand then even, yeah, I think it would still be a little bit on the loose side. I'm not sure whether like maybe a bit of blue tack on the end of a pencil or something might help, or I don't know how you get the blue tack back out again. The other thing to do is potentially get them printed with a lid on them so that they are a solid barrel instead, because I do have a set of lids somewhere in my box of scenery, but because they're so small, they've all gone to the bottom of the box, so I need to go digging them out at some point. I've just a bone now that I've completely and utterly painted over. Move on to this pile of bones. Having a quick look to see if there's any check some more music choices out after the stream. Using Pretzel Rocks for the music. Four more skulls on this side as well. Are these for a certain game or for general use? These are part of the Age of Sigmar scenery at Games Workshop, but I will be using them in general use for pictures and such. I am not really much of a war gamer myself, like I wouldn't play games with these, but I just wanted some things for backgrounds to go with some models, because I've got quite a few like studio sets of photos of my models, but I just think it would just add to the scenery a little bit if there was, you know, a little bit more to the backgrounds more than anything. So I was kind of looking forward to getting some more background. I'm doing this particular set in sort of a sandy desert feel, and then I've got the other set, which I can't remember the name of, I think it's a Sigmarite set, I can't remember, from Age of Sigma. And that's going to be more of an icy, cool, dark, night haunty type style. So I've got two sets of scenery on the go at the minute. Just trying to get this one done because I've done quite a lot of this set. And about the bits I'm working on, making me about halfway through the whole set, so I'm definitely looking forward to getting these done. Just check if these guys are dry. You know what, they're not half bad actually. Let's zoom out a bit because these guys are a bit on the larger side. I've got two of these that I'm working on at the minute as well. I'm going to be using Ironman Blue, but I'm going to be using it as more of a dry paint, so I'm just getting my setup ready to be doing some dry brushing. It's very cool. Do you have like an Instagram or website of stuff you've done? I do. My YouTube is going to have a lot of shorts on it coming up soon. My Instagram and Twitter and everything is at Miss Dibbler, a spell on the channel here, so you can pretty much find me anywhere at Miss Dibbler. But yeah, Instagram, TikTok, I'm starting YouTube and TikTok, I'm just starting out on. Instagram's got the majority of my pictures on. Got some of my favourite models to hand because I just absolutely love showing them off. So this is the Avatar of Kane, this is the old Forge World model. This is my absolute, yeah, he's my favourite. I like having him to hand, I like showing him off. Right. Make sure I've got the right dry brush, that one. Really nice actually with the Ironman Blue on it. Oh, thank you very much, King. That's very kind of you to say. You're helping a buddy assemble his first army and he's getting into Eldari. Well, I am pretty much very heavily Eldari in everything that I've got. That was the first army that I got as well. I did quite a lot of Drakari, Craft World. My Harlequins were the first ones that I've done. Got my Harlequin set here. These were the first set that I did. So at the minute, very, very heavily Eldari, and recently started collecting the Chaos, because, I mean, I'm corrupt enough already, right? Yeah, I paint mostly for myself, for my own hobby, and honestly just love painting models that look cool. Models cool, I'll be painting it. This looks a bit scary and a bit green at first, but I'll be going over with a non-oil gloss afterwards, so I'll kind of like turn it down a bit after. That's what I love about this hobby. You don't have to play to be a part of it, you can just be into painting, building, etc. Yeah, definitely. Absolutely. And I think, you know, what GW have got with that side of things is amazing. Like, I know there's an awful lot of people out there that are very much into the wargaming side of stuff, and I just find it so complicated, and then when I've just got my head around the rules, they've been changed again, or there's been adjustments made that are not in the books, or my set of rules aren't up to date anymore, and I was getting so stressed about it that it kind of didn't really click with me as part of the hobby. But this painting and art side of stuff, I absolutely love. Tell you what, I can see on camera better about where some of the highlights need to be than I can in person, so he's definitely taking shape, he's looking awesome. I also love that there's absolutely no rules with the painting side of stuff. I mean, loosely speaking, I know there's certain factions in the space marine side of stuff that are like, oh, they have to be these colours. And at some point I'm thinking of doing a let's try and paint one model from each legion, which I think would be quite fun to do, just out of curiosity really, but they're not really something I would collect much of. But yeah, definitely looking forward to just experimenting a little bit. No, I don't know why I'm dry brushing that ball in his hand. I know I'm painting that gold in a bit. Never mind. I'm trying to paint one side of the stick because it's very easy to like dry brush all of it, so pick up a few highlights, but most part, let's just concentrate the highlight on one bit. Oops, I'm not quite sure what happened though. So much out of that model actually. I feel like his head needs a little bit more at the top and the back. I'm gonna leave him to one side to dry. Looks a bit scary at the minute, but it will be toned down. So by the time I've done the other one, it should be dry enough for shade paints. Stuck my finger in the paint, that was wonderful. Oh, thanks for the follow, King. That's very much appreciated. Through the paper. No. Just check it. Might just be me, but I enjoy how dry brushing sounds oddly satisfying, plus it looks amazing. Yeah, I must admit, dry brushing is my absolute favourite part of painting, because it just brings out the whole model. Like, I'm gonna end up going back to barrels here for a second, but if I wasn't throwing them everywhere. Still throwing them everywhere. So one of these barrels was not painted with contrast paint. This one was painted with some much darker colours and shaded and dry brushed. I was just kind of curious the differences between contrast and painting it the old way, really, and the dry brushing just sort of kind of made it look so much better. But also, how good are these contrast paints? Because you cannot tell which one of these was painted the old way and which way is with the new contrast paint. So for stuff like this, some of the contrast paints are just magic. But yeah, the dry brushing just kind of gives it that extra elevated look. It stops it looking really flat. Ooh, that was a bit too much paint on that, actually. Oh dear. I also love how dry brushing kind of can sometimes give you that airbrush look on some parts of the models, especially on like the bigger, flatter areas. It's, if you just concentrate it a little bit in one area, it just kind of really just brings it to life and just gives it that extra little bit of, a little bit extra 3D-ness and detail, I think is the best way of describing it. And these scales, it's difficult, especially around this area here, because I don't want to break the I think it was about there on the other model, wasn't it? Yep. So make sure I've got it right in the same bit on both models. How long have I been painting? I've been painting since about 2019, but I took about a year break through COVID, so not particularly that long in the grand scheme of stuff, really. I'm trying to hold this model as steady as possible while I'm dry brushing, but you just end up scrubbing at it, so it just ends up moving. Just get all the highlights on this pauldron. The last bit of this hammer to do and see how the first one is, because I might be able to start shading that. want to just compare the two, just make sure they're both okay. I think I've kind of hit all the same places really. This one's going to be a bit darker because it's dried a bit more. Okay, I think we're ready for shade on that one. If I can find it. Here we go. So I'm using the glossy non-oil to bring this out. Let's move this. Oh, just cleaning my brush, it's taking a bit of cleaning. Non-oil, it's a Necron player that has been a key part of your painting, yeah. I must admit, I have far too much non-oil compared to any other shade paint. It is absolutely amazing. As clean as I'm getting that for now. Clean that properly after stream. So I'm gonna get my big shade brush out. So this normal oil, it just kind of tones the green down a little bit, but also I want these models to kind of look a bit like obsidian, which is usually quite a shiny stone or gemstone. So I am definitely looking for the glossy look at the end for this model. Still on the lookout on how to make these extremely shiny. Because although it does leave a glossy finish, part of me is thinking that they could be even shinier. So that's definitely the look I'm going for with these. Yeah. Can you paint everywhere? Really not my shade paint over then. They're just gonna dry to the side. Can I work on today? I've got these guys, which I've finished up to the point where I've got with those, and I've just got the gold detailing to do on these. gonna mute while I shake this one. It's a bit. There we go. My machine's a little bit noisy, that's all. So I'm going back in with a small layer. Yep, small layer. So this is Balthazar Gold from Citadel. The paint mixer is on your to-buy list. They are so handy. Yeah, I agree. I had a just over a year and a half break from painting, which meant that all of my paints had been splitting for that entire period, and I didn't have a single paint loss, but having to mix all of my paints back up just to make sure they were okay just in case I needed to replace them. I didn't have a single lossage, and that paint mixer saved my hands, my elbows, my arms. The one I've got is £30 off Amazon, so it's really fairly cheap, really, and absolutely worth the money. chains are so fiddly. Let's just make sure you get all sides of them as well. It'd be worth it. Just keep telling myself it's worth it. Quite glad that this gold is very slightly darker than the sandstone colour, because I did try on a different piece, the gold, and it blended in a bit, and I was a bit worried. But it looks fantastic next to the black, and it is actually a different colour from the sand, which is fantastic. I think you can do these little handles on here as well. They are of course going to be shaded later when they are dry. I think I'm now going to end the stream for today. I'm gonna find somebody to raid. Thank you very much for joining today.